when news came out late Monday that Apple will go ahead with a 2024 date and target date for an EV iCar, they instantly got thrust into the EV space and became direct competition, possibly, to Tesla. In this video, we'll discuss the possible direct head-to-head coming between Tesla and Apple. Let's talk Tesla and Apple, guys. Neil and Sean joining me as always, guys. Big news came out late in the day on Monday this week that Apple will go ahead with an iCar targeting 2024 for first production. When it comes to the actual trading, how we can approach this going forward, now we're talking, you know, first off, is Apple even competition for Tesla at this point or any time in the future? And if so, how are we going to trade this?
Yeah, to answer your first question, I think, Neil, are they competition? Yes. I mean, Apple is competition to any space they step into. And we've hinted on this on the show as well. Just the brand loyalty between Apple and Tesla are both just so super strong. And I really feel that, although we'll talk to Randy if it's right that Apple gets into the car space. We'll talk about that soon. But if they're going to, they talked about 2024. And look, it's just another catalyst. I mean, that's such a key word. This is when it came out on Monday, the 21st of December. Apple was kind of cruising, was already having a nice day. You wonder if someone knew about that down here. But then, you know, comes out, dropped on Reuters that this is possibly what's happened. And then we've seen the EV space just going nuts. And then this is what happens to Apple. It gains billions and billions in market cap off this 126 bottom there, rips up the rest of the day to 129. Opens then on Tuesday, high 134, almost back to all-time highs. And then we trade today, which, of course, is Wednesday, the 23rd. And it's not doing too much today. You're still up that, now you're down 0.25%. But if we look at a daily chart on Apple here, this is the key for me. Look at this move. I mean, nothing really stops this thing. Not only are they selling an unlimited amount of iPhones, iPads, they now have the headsets as well, everything. They're into credit cards, and now they're going to go into EV space. They almost make the high. This is pre-split. So this is the move up when they were going to split. Then you get the move down. I think we take this 137.50 out. And by the way, if they get into the EV space, then it also needs to get added to some of those EV ETFs as well. So for me, Apple remains a long, and it's going to remain that way for quite a long time. Just keep buying dips, in my opinion. The next dip probably to about 125, where we went to. And again, remember the level that we started at, guys, was right down here, 126 and change. So that could come into play again, 126. That's the level that it came out at when they announced this possible, you know, entry into the EV space.
Yeah, and look, as you said there, Sean, Apple's a behemoth. They're a beast. They got the cult following. And that's part of the reason why when you think about Tesla, they haven't really had competitors. When you ask people if they were looking at an electrical vehicle, their answer is going to be, yeah, you know, maybe I'm interested in getting a Tesla, or I've been looking at getting a Tesla. They don't say, that Neo vehicle or Candy. Like, it's just, you're like, it's like tissue when it comes to this point. Like, they just are the EV space. All that said, as much as Tesla has shrugged off NIO and some of the other Chinese automakers, electrical vehicle makers, despite the fact that that is a much bigger market than you have in the US and Europe, it's gigantic and lots of opportunities there, will Tesla shrug this one off? Possibly. But if you start thinking about the other event that just happened on Tesla, and that's the inclusion of the S&P 500, it was a massive ramp up. You had a nice little consolidation at 420 and then a move up to 695, which was, again, just the closing print when you did have that inclusion. Really, the top is more like a 680 looking at the 15-minute chart here. So you'd already made that kind of a high. And coming into the week, people were already starting to think about, okay, sell the news. It's probably a good point to start pulling back on Tesla. And then you did have this news drop. So I think from a day trading perspective, you can put your pink shorts on and start looking at some opportunities to play a weakness in Tesla off of the 680 level, which is sort of come and gone. Now looking at a 650 to 660 area, if those break, I think there's going to be some chop into that 680 to 695 range. So there might be a few breaks to the long side. And then outside of that, you're probably looking for more extended dips to be able to buy into some more. Well, the caveat I'll put in here is, of course, you know, there's going to be some tax selling implications where maybe some selling comes in January and you want to wait for deeper pushes to something like a 610 or like a 550, where I think the bulls are definitely going to be loading up at those prices if they get a shot at Tesla. It's a bit of a shot in the arm, double shot to the short side here. And that's why even today, when we got a bit of a gap, not a gap up, but a push off of 25 into that 50 area, it's just a hard resistance. And then, you know, if I can zoom in and just quickly show you, and forget about these little dark pool prints, it was just a hard turn off 650 so far. So some of these levels are starting to be a little bit more attractive from a short-term perspective to be able to short. And then just play patience when it comes to buying in these dips, because, you know, you're not shrugging off Apple the same way you're going to shrug all of these other names that have come into the space at the end of the year. And Sean definitely nailed it when he talked about Apple needing to potentially be added to some of the EV indexes. If this does happen, of course, to learn a bit about more if they should do it and how it would look, let's bring in our resident expert. You know, we're going to go back to you, Brendan, and our resident expert, Randy.
Yeah, so here's there's a look at the technical side of this possibility and going forward from a technical aspect, what, you know, it could look like from a trade standpoint. As Neil teed it up there, we brought our resident automotive expert in to discuss the more fundamental side of the possibility of this happening. Randy Bucking joining me to have a chat about, you know, from a fundamental standpoint, Randy, what has to happen first off for this to happen for Apple, and just your general thoughts on what they're going to need to do to make this a possibility?
So Neil and Sean, you guys had it right. These guys are behemoths. They have a lot of loyal customers. You often wonder how many people who drive Teslas actually have an iPhone in their pocket or an iPad at home. We got a loyal fan base. We have a huge market cap. Apple has the resources and they have some of the people. Don't forget, Tesla's been in the business for a long time. They've got the people, they've got the supply chain. They've got a lot of customer base existing now. Apple doesn't have that. Apple's got the money. They've got the resources. They don't have the people. And I see this taking time. This project's been on the bench for about a couple of years, and then they abandoned it last year. They have reassembled a new team, and they've got new battery technology. Will that be enough to bring a car to market that undercuts the three? Possibly. They want a car for everybody. Everybody has iPhones. They want that market penetration. Teslas are kind of expensive. They're not the cheapest thing out there. They're a niche product. They're selling like hotcakes, but Apple wants a bigger piece of the pie. So if they can bring new battery technology in and get the right people, and the people is key, because don't forget, there's only so many engineers out there that actually can build cars. And do they take people from Tesla or from GM and Ford or existing automakers and bring them into the fold? This is gonna take time. Apple has the money. They have some time. They put a 2024 date on this. I think it's a little premature, we'll see. Getting the resources and stepping into a different sector is a big step for them. They've just done it in the fitness sector. We had that come out just before Black Friday, I think it was. Apple's now in the fitness center, taking on Fitbit and the likes of that. Now the automotive, not as easy as a step. Apple's done great with their own products. They've now walked away from Intel. The new processors in the MacBook Pro, for example, are actually faster than the Intel chips they were using. So they've proven that they can get into another sector, control a supply chain, and take the middleman out. Doing that in the EV sector is going to be a little more difficult. There's suppliers they have to deal with for things like axles and glass and brakes, stuff that Apple doesn't currently make. They still need their suppliers. They've got Foxconn building, you know, AirPods and iPads and all the rest of it. They're going to need a supplier to build body panels and brakes and, you know, transmissions and things like that. They've got to approach suppliers, find a supplier that has, maybe it's Volkswagen, maybe it's Magna, that has this chassis that they can build their software and their AI on top of, and then bring the price down so they can penetrate this market. It's not going to be an easy step, but they've got the resources, but it's going to take time.
They've shown over time with the iPhone that, you know, people are willing to kind of expand what they are used to when it comes to a price zone for the iPhone. You know, we're up into, you know, in this country anyways, the $1,500 to $2,000 level for a phone, which is now the norm, right? Because they've kind of pushed it in that direction. So, you know, you say they want to try and make a car for everyone. What would that kind of price range need to be? We're obviously speculating here, but what would that kind of price range need to be given that Tesla is at the higher end?
I would expect them to come in around the Model 3 neck of the woods. The Model 3 has had great penetration. The Model Y is also on the dartboard because it's a crossover. They're hot right now. Not everybody wants a sedan. If they can get in that 50,000 US price range and actually bring the battery costs down, bring their supply chain costs down to the point where they're making that much more profit than Tesla. Don't forget, Tesla's not that profitable. Their market cap is huge, but they're not that profitable yet. Apple's got money to burn. If they can bring their costs down, control their supply chain, eliminate the Intels in the supply chain and get as much control and bring their costs down and still keep the price in the 50,000-ish range, they'll sell like crazy.
So bottom line is, can they get this done? And if so, is the 2024 date doable?
I think it's premature. This being said, that there's engineers and the right people that you need to help spend that money, to find the right products, to get the suppliers in line, to bring capacity online. There's been capacity problems because of the pandemic. So the factories are not running at full blast. It's going to be difficult. That being said, they've got a lot of resources. I think the people is going to be their biggest hang up. It's going to be a resource that they're going to really have to work on. The suppliers are out there. We've looked at Magna today, for example. Magna's teaming up with LG. They've got other car companies that are approaching Magna for their platform. There's existing platforms by Volkswagen that are out there now that are licensable. You know, Elon approached Tim Cook when he saw the tweet just the other day, and Apple's going to go this alone. They are. They're not going to go and buy a Rivian. They're not going to go buy Tesla. They want to go this alone like they have done with Intel and their processors. That's going to take time.
One thing for certain, given the brand loyalty, an iCar will no doubt be a hit. Whether or not it will happen, we will have to wait and see. Whether or not they will be direct competition for Tesla, we will have to wait and see. So there's a look, guys, at first off, Apple moving into the EV space, and will they or will they not be direct competition for Tesla? We seem to believe that both are possible. Let's go to Valeria.
Hey guys, thank you for this great information. Dear viewers, please subscribe to this channel to see more great videos.